Good evening. Police now have suspects in the mid-December shooting of a Lee Summit teenager.
KMBC 9's Marcus Moore is live at the Lee Summit police station tonight with the news we first broke at 5. Marcus?
Kelly, police have arrested two teenagers, 17-year-old Kevin Jordan and 17-year-old John F. Roddy. Both of those teenagers charged in this case tonight, and both of them are from Lee Summit. Police have accused them of being in connection with the attempted carjacking and shooting of 18-year-old Tierra Singleton. Now, that shooting happened on December 19th as she was backing out of her driveway from her Lee Summit home. Police arrested these two suspects last night, and they have been in touch with Singleton's parents, who say the news is encouraging.
Her father, in his words, said that he's very elated, and he feels that this is the information that she will truly appreciate to make her more comfortable in coming home, because that's an uncomfortable thing for her to return to the residence, so he's hoping this will make her feel better.
Now, police arrested Roddy and Jordan last night as they were circling Lee Summit North High School after a shooting that happened there shortly after a basketball game. It turns out that the juvenile who was arrested there and who allegedly, according to police, had a shotgun and fired that shotgun, he apparently is related to one of the suspects in this attempted carjacking and shooting that happened on December 19th. So tonight, police are continuing to investigate this case, and from what we understand from police, one of the suspects, actually Kevin Jordan, actually confessed to police his alleged involvement in the attempted carjacking and shooting. We'll have more on that tonight at 10 o'clock. For now, reporting live in Lee Summit, I'm Marcus Moore, KMBC 9 News.
All right, Marcus, thank you. Now, with respect to the shots fired last night, the Lee Summit School District did release a statement on its website. It says, in part, our 7 school district officials are grateful for the quick actions of both Lee Summit High School and Lee Summit North High School staff members, as well as the outstanding response from the Lee Summit Police Department. Students are to be commended for their cooperation with school staff and police officers Friday evening. As always, the goal of the R7 School District is to maintain a safe learning environment for students and staff members at school and at school events. Now, the district said it used the school district's recorded voice message system to call all parents from the two high schools this morning to inform them about the incident.